Impactful projects are the most important thing on your resume to secure your first internship. And impactful projects mean coding projects that involve real problems used by real users and can be quantified on your resume with numbers. Today, we're going to trivialize the process of finding impactful projects. I'm Zach. I've been fortunate. Offers from Google, Meta, and some tier 1 trading firms. Trust me, I had a really hard time getting started. What worked for me was building small tools that helped real communities and tracking the impact along the way. So this video is for students and anyone hoping for their first real programming experience outside of classrooms. We found easy venues, reusable templates, and seriously impressive measurements. First, story time. When I was in college, I built a bot that ranked students' study time on Discord and got hundreds of thousands of users within a year. It was later used by companies that raised a total of $18 million in funding. So yes, Discord has real users and real pain. Don't reinvent existing megabots. Add a bot to automate something simple or fix an existing bug for a semi-established server that hopefully you're already in. That's what I did. You can message the server owner or mod, "Hey mod name, I've been in this server for years and noticed specific pain or missing features. I like building impactful side projects for fun and for my resume. So, I would love to add feature X or fix bug Y and share the full source code back for free. Would that work?" Typically, you can do something small like a simple command or a trigger that's immediately visible to the users. So you can track the number of times the users have invoked your command since you launched it, the number of users has impacted, or the number of hours you have saved. The Discord ecosystem would not be what it is today without the open source spirit, which is why I put the source code behind my own Discord bot on GitHub for everyone to see. In fact, if you want to get a deep dive into the full dev story, comment Discord. The second venue for us is open source. Open source is basically just public teamwork. You can start tiny and ramp up. There's this repository called Awesome for Beginners. You can find specific and active repositories that are seeking help in your favorite programming language. Just say something like, "Can I take on this issue?" After you have fixed that issue, you can ask maintainers what bugs or recurring pain you can solve next. The measurements could be the number of MRs merged, the issues closed, or even how much you have raised their test coverage. Another crowd that heavily relies on open source tools are professors. In fact, if you are a student, here's a hot take. You literally pay professors to teach and mentor you. It is their job to help you, so cash it in. Be polite and specific, but don't be shy. I will have all the templates in the video description for the sake of time. If you're a student, you want to search your school undergraduate research program. Typically, colleges offer paid research programs that pair students like you with professors. And you can also alternatively reach out to the professor directly, since a professor could have many side projects as well or hire you as their TA. But for majors, you can have hours saved, the amount of data maybe in gigabytes you have processed, the speed up you have done for maybe the online judge for homework. In fact, your professors might also be able to introduce you to startups founded by their past students. Alumni founders and local meetups are side quests with real loot. Ask if you can help with anything or intern there. As for majors, you can just do a before and after comparison for maybe the amount of hours you have saved from DevOps, how much you have reduced their software error rate, or since you started working, how much improvement have you seen in the conversion rate. If you want a more traditional job, hear this. The college IT system is a production system within your walking distance. It has identity management, websites, and tickets. Plus, you can get to fix the thing that you and your peers complain about daily. For example, the course registration system. You can just search on Google, yourschool.edu, IT student, or yourschool.edu, student web developer, or handshake student developer. As for majors, you can track the mean time to respond, the number of tickets you close per week, or the deploy time, uptime, etc. If you prefer something more lightweight, clubs are an excellent choice. Clubs are almost always in need of website improvements or new content, event pages, sign up flow. For this one, I actually recommend going there in person to talk to the club president, because it would show that you are actually engaged in the community and help build trust. As for management, you can get page views, signups, click-through rate, and maybe newsletter subscriber increase. I got some really good memories, personally, from participating in clubs, but the highlights are often the hackathons that we went to together. Hackathons are events where people code up a mini or demo project over a weekend or a week. They're like speed dating for programmers. And you only need to show up with your laptop. Most events will give you some overarching topic, and people will mingle and form into teams, then brainstorming happens fast. It is significantly easier than speed dating in real life, isn't it? And to find the hackathons, you can search dev post, upcoming, or MLH events, or student hackathons near me, or even open hack night in your city name. After winning many hackathons, these days I'm more on the other side of the table as a judge. My personal winning formula is one real user persona to touch the judges, and some real APIs like OpenAI or Stripe. So, speaking of mini projects, I actually built a CV generator once, and it has been surprisingly useful ever since, because many companies still ask you to submit a CV besides a resume in 2025. You know what? If you comment CV, I can share and walk through my CV generator in a new video. So they are all of our venues for easy but impactful projects. If you haven't found out, the time till the next video on my channel follows this exact formula. So please definitely subscribe, like, and comment. Remember, start tiny and increase the scope. At the end, before you realize it, you can have a killer resume. Peace.